Good afternoon and welcome. What a proud day for all of you, graduates, parents, spouses, children, and friends. I am Marion Broom, the Dean of the Duke University School of Nursing. I welcome you to this very special occasion when we celebrate the individual and collective accomplishments of the graduates who will be recognized today. Additionally, I would like to recognize and thank all of our faculty, clinical nurse educators, and clinical instructors who are also here with us today. The over-the-top contributions of these individuals during our students' programs have helped today's graduates achieve their professional goals. I would also like to thank the staff in the Office of Admissions and Student Services for coordinating this event. It looks smooth, but it takes a lot of coordination. Before we begin today's ceremony, I'd also like to offer a welcome to a number of special guests and friends of the school in the audience. I'll ask that each rise when I call their names. Dr. Cheryl Brewer, PDC Associate Vice President, Nursing and Nursing Alumni Council Secretary. Dr. Marianne Fuchs, Vice President of Patient Care and System Chief Nurse Executive, Duke University Health System. Dr. Vicki Orto, Chief Nurse, Nursing and Patient Care Services Officer, Duke Regional Hospital. And Dr. Priscilla Rimsour, Chief Nursing and Patient Care Services Officer, Duke Raleigh Hospital. And last but not least, Dr. Ruby Wilson, Dean Emerita of the Duke University School of Nursing. Thank you for being here to celebrate with us on this special occasion. And most of all, thank you for all you do to enable our students to practice in one of the finest health systems in the world. It is now my privilege to introduce Nicole Benson, who has been selected to speak on behalf of all of our graduating students. Nicole is a May 2017 graduate of our Doctor of Nursing Practice program. Okay. I was just wondering.
I didn't think at 5'7" I would be considered short. So I'm going off the cuff a little bit at the beginning here, but I wanted to take the time to say Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there that are very proud of their babies graduating today. Especially to my mommy who's here in the audience. Additionally, I would like to thank Dr. Ann Derwin for her mentoring, wisdom, and most of all, friendship for these last 3 years. Welcome to the faculty, staff, friends, family, and to you, students. Congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places, you're off and away. Oh, the places you will go. Dr. Seuss had it correctly penned in his last published book in 1990. Oh, the places you will go. I recently bought 2 copies of this book, unbeknownst to my children, to have each one of their grade school teachers write an inspiring word or two in their copy into their high school graduation, where I will secretly and emotionally present it to them. Although I think I just ruined the surprise. But I doubt they'll remember it since they're currently 5 and almost 3 years old. And they can't remember where they put their shoes, let alone remember where a 12-year-old in the making present spoken during my graduation ceremony. As I read the book, I was struck by how relevant it is to our journeys in our life and how it beautifully explains what I want for my children to understand, dream, reach for, and achieve. I want them to make a difference in this world. And it is what we, as nurses, graduating from this esteemed university, are now trained to do. We are off to great places. Now, we may not know exactly where all those places are, but we have the tools to see bigger pictures, to reach for better ways of delivering evidence-based care, to achieve all that we as professionals can do, and to make a difference for our patients, our families, and the communities we serve. This book exemplifies what life is. Life is a journey with hopefully very little waiting, a journey with highs and lows, and the fortitude to keep you reaching and striving for more. Now, I have had some pauses and periods of waiting on my life's journey so far. Now, people are surprised when they learn that before I became a nurse, I earned a bachelor's degree in music, communication, and theater arts. But I see those degrees as part of my journey that allowed me the sheer ability and courage to stand before you today. People are amazed that I used to be an entertainment manager and stilt walker at a well-known theme park in Orlando. This experience contributed to my journey that allowed me to gain the people skills to practice as a professional nurse. And some people are in awe that I am serving my country as an active duty naval officer and will continue to do so for the coming years. Thank you. The skills I learned throughout my journey as an officer were of resiliency and integrity, which inspired me to go back to school to become a pediatric nurse practitioner and immediately continue on to my DNP. It is interesting how all those diverse chapters in my life helped me succeed in this goal and will lead me towards a future that is just unfolding. Just like me, each of you have stories and journeys that brought you to this point in your careers and lives. Each of your stories, no matter how large or how small, matter. They affect us. These background stories make us who we are, and through these experiences, help us gain a little more insight into the world around us. Throughout each step of our journeys, we become wiser, better, and stronger people through the growth of our experiences. As I prepared for this speech, I reflected on all the challenges in my journey as I learned to manage for the care of infants and children with special needs, collected data for my DNP scholarly project, and waited for my husband, also in the Navy, to return home from deployment twice in the 3 years of my graduate education. Yes, you heard me right. He deployed twice in 3 years, leaving me alone, thank you, with 2 small children. My youngest was 2.5 months old when I started my master's studies. Those were challenging days, which required me to use resiliency, focus, determination, and creativity, all skills built throughout my journey. And despite the bumps in the road, we're here together on this glorious day. I know that I will have looming days ahead, and that will include uphill battles. But I am also confident that I will be able to find solutions and succeed in my role as an advanced practice nurse. Some of you may face challenges in the form of caring for an altered mental status patient, trying to complete endless charting before the days or weeks end, managing the agenda, or addressing your nurse executive leadership commitments. Think about the commitment it took to come back to school. All of the physical and emotional turmoil as you faced as a Duke student, and how much you are now prepared for those future challenges. Think of how much stronger your character is and how much strength you will be able to garnish as a leader. Whatever your professional role, use your experience as well as your vision for the future to confidently go forward on your way. Stand tall and breathe, just like you did with your studies, and take every demand one at a time. Trust your gut and lead with integrity and evidence-based practice. Most of all, remember those who helped you get you where you are now. Be it your parents, your spouse, your partner, a friend, or your children. Consider those that paved your way, paid your way, or inspired your way. I am the first generation born in America on my mother's side. My grandparents brought my mother to this children so their family could be a testament that any dream can come true as long as you work hard, keep the faith, and once you achieve something, pay it forward. They inspired me to become the doctor of nursing practice I am today. Sadly, my grandmother passed this past February before she could fully see the fruits of her labors come to fruition as having a doctor in the family. But I know she's looking down on all of us today and is beaming proudly. Remember to thank your person or your people who helped get you here today. And do not get lost in the trials and tribulations of your new career that you forget them. Life's journey is incomplete without your loved ones. So whether you're graduating today with your accelerated BSN, MSN, post-master certificate, DNP, or PhD, we have all taken a journey to get to this day. Remember the pain, but remember the joy, because it is what brought you here. Learn from it, grow from it, and never lose sight of who you are. In closing, I would like to finish with the final published words of Dr. Seuss. Excuse me. Be your name Baxham or Bixby or Bray, or Mordecai Ali, Vo Allen or Shay. You're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting. So get on your way. Congratulations to the Duke University School of Nursing, class of 2017. Let me take this off.
Yes, ma'am. Just by you, and then don't go anywhere. No. Don't go anywhere. That was excellent, Lieutenant Commander Nelson, and it was very inspirational and very optimistic. But who could do this if they weren't such an optimist? This is just a small token of our thank you for spending time preparing such a speech and making us all think about why we went to school and how good the rest of life can be.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Let me just measure it up. Okay, don't I'll put your skills to work.
Thank you so much.
Each year, the school recognizes students for academic and clinical excellence. Many of the student awards were presented on Friday at the annual faculty, staff, and students award ceremony. It was a very inspirational afternoon. The description of each award is listed in your program. However, I would also like to take this opportunity again to congratulate those recognized. Students, as I call your name, please stand and stay standing. Annie Beery Bieber Award for Outstanding Leadership, Darlene Marie Rogers. Outstanding DNP Scholarly Project Award, Ariella Rosalie Jolly. Ruby L. Wilson Excellence in Clinical Practice Award, Ian Power Ryan. Thelma Ingalls Award, Susan Klein Herndon. The Bonnie Jones Friedman Humanitarian Award, Tanya Lynn Crespo. Congratulations again. And now we move to the part of the ceremony that everyone was looking forward to, the presentation of the graduates. At this time, we will recognize students earning their Doctor of Philosophy, better known as PhD, Doctor of Nursing Practice, or DNP, Master of Science in Nursing, Certificate Awardees, and Accelerated Bachelor of Science in Nursing degrees. We will begin by hooding our PhD graduates. I now invite Dr. Deborah Brandon, PhD Program Director, to the lectern.
Thank you, Dean Broom. It is my pleasure to present the Duke School of Nursing graduates for the PhD degree. PhD graduates are prepared as nurse scientists to develop new knowledge that will improve the health of individuals, caregiving systems, and communities. The PhD graduates will come forward and be hooded today with the assistance from their dissertation chair and a faculty member. Latifa Dardis. Nancy Diaz. Dennis Flores. Rachel Hershey. Miriam Kale. Brittany Sullivan. Megan Winkler. Rose Xavier. Congratulations to the PhD graduates. I now call Dr. Kathy Pereira, DMP Program Director, to the lectern.
Thank you, Dr. Brandon. It is my utmost pleasure to present the graduates for the Doctor of Nursing Practice degree. These graduates have been prepared to lead in the healthcare system of the future. They will bring solutions to the gaps in care, and they will evaluate current practices looking for opportunities for improvement. Each DNP graduate will come forward and be hooded today with the assistance of two faculty members. The first is the faculty member who chaired the final scholarly project, and the second is Dr. Valerie Sable, one of our division chairs. The name of each graduate, the title of their project, and the DNP scholarly project advisor are listed in your printed program. Sandra Ann Richardson. Teresa Harris Catting. Catherine Marie Bach. Christina Renee Giambalvo. Obiamaka Oji. Rebecca Ann Smith Seeley. Laura Beth Miller. Connie Sue Obenrotter. Julianne Peck Rendon. Judith K. Glan. James Richard Reed. Sarah Lynn Bonkowski. Lieutenant Commander Nicole Denise Benson, United States Navy. Samantha Lee Gardner. Caitlin Emily Basemore. Meredith Blair Bedsworth. Allison Booth Stubberud. Amanda M. Kirby. Regal Ado Angelo Valerio Jr. Anastasia Jean Jester. Stephanie Ann Hisgen. Sarah Lynn Snell. Brandy Nicole Tinsbloom. John Douglas Berger. Kristen McGinnis Blanc. John Stevenson Thomas.
Terry Ann Moore Harper. Ederlina Pexen Lendetta. Jennifer Schieferle Uhlenbrock. Catherine Elizabeth McNabb.
Tracy R. Adams. Karen Lise Harden. Margaret Marie Westner. Ariella Rosalie Jolly. Courtney Elizabeth Smith. Warren Albert Stewart. Katie Paul Worthington. Anna Skripnik Lucas. Susan Haynes Little. Era Ashley Millett. Allison K. Ong. Joel Brandon Brock. Sandra Lucinda Garrity. Kimberly Ann Bagley. Kelly Christine Amperan. Amy Davis Bell. Stephanie Nicole Brogdon. Victoria Lee Eads. Matthew Edward Hayes. Lauren K. Schnitzen. Dina Glasgow Starr. Jennifer Jo Franklin. Seth Christensen Hansen. Ashley Thrasher Riddick. Gwen Elise Klinkner. K. Jaleo Lee. Ashley Moore Gibbs. Congratulations, DNP graduates. I will now call upon Dr. Michael Zykowitz, MSN Program Director, to the podium. Dr. Zykowitz.
Happy Mother's Day, everybody. Thank you, Dr. Pereira. It's my pleasure to present the graduates for the Masters of Science in Nursing and Certificate awardees. Graduates will be greeted by Assistant Professor and Chair of the MSN Program Committee, Dr. Sherry Rushton, and Dr. Aliki Martin, Alumni Association President. Emily E. Aldridge. Afua Anchui. Jessica Lee Arce. Daryl April Asuncion. Teresa Sanchez Avery. Twyla Dawn Bergenstahl. Alexandria Diane Black. Joanna Barlow Bowman. Jeremy Kendall Britt. Francesca Colette Brown. Keely Danielle Bergen. Angela Michelle Bird. Millie K. Carlson. Caitlin Gaskins Carnwath. Heidi Davies Chappelle. Catherine L. Cochran. Tanya Lynn Crespo. Charlotte Amanda Culliver. Janine Mary Cummings. Lasagna Adele Davis. Kelsey Ellis Decker. Kimberly S. Denty. Brian Duthit. Catalina Marie Eubanks. Kimberly Michelle Fisher. Heather Nicole Flowers. Tegan Flowers. Vincent Guillermo Ramos. Felicia Bell Hammonds. Ashley Renee Harper. Tiffany Lynn Harriman. Susan Doss Hawkins. Emily Brandmeyer Healy. Susan Klein Herndon. Meredith Slager Hirsch. Elizabeth Ann Hoffman. Amy Yu Ein Hoi. Lacey Marie Jennings. Hannah Dimsdale Johnson. Alicia Ann Jones. Jessica Blair Kabul. Emily K. Kahn. Evdasia Gloria Karagounis. Cassandra Kirstein. Austin Elaine LaCrosse. Jose Ramon Lara. Lawrence Dennis LaDuff III. Jennifer Kristen Lenchick. Ping Lee. Amanda Ashley Lynch. Tasha K. Martin Peters. Lorena Dunbar Mani. Megan Renee McAllister. Kelly Clark McBride. Michael McGinnis. Karen Ashley Lane Messick. Christina Nicole Michael. Caitlin Elizabeth Mize. Shalane Beth Moore. Sandra Mora. Olivia Marie Murphy. Sarah Denise Namek. Marissa Navaroli. Rosalyn Bonareri Ankundi. Susan Wilhelm Patterson. Ashaki Phillips. Michelle Marie Petricola. Ivana Johnsel Plymouth. Yeah. Kathleen Marie Rohleder. Captain Alyssa Nolani Sanquist, United States Air Force. Samrit Kaur Saran. Marianne Savage. Heather Ann Schneider. Catherine Simpson. Sierra Sherry Singleton. Mandy Nicole Smith. Leisha Ann Steed. Shay Sumner. Shanitra Swinney. Chelsea Danielle Taylor. Tyler Daniel Terry. Mary Beth Colleen Tetlow. Patricia Jarman Tierney. Lisa Ann Tassone. Michelle Lee Toller. Peggy Ann Ursi. Tristan Valdivia. Chad Frederick Walls. Caitlin E. Waring. Margot Elizabeth Waters. Kendra Pearl Watts. Hillary McIntosh Whitehorn. Claudia Frank Williams. Ashley Nicole Williams. Robert John Wiltberger. Abigail Marie Wolf. So that concludes the presentation of the Master's and Certificate graduates. Congratulations, everyone. I'd like to now call Dr. Beth Phillips, Associate Professor, to the lectern.
It is my pleasure to begin the presentation of graduates for the Bachelor of Science in Nursing degree. Graduates will be greeted by ABSN Assistant Professor and Faculty Leader. As each student's name is read, they will be presented with their Duke University School of Nursing pin. The gold pin serves as a symbolic welcome to the nursing profession and signifies the student's academic program completion achievement. Avery Marie Anderson. Gabriella Carolina Arce Matos. Jordan Thomas Armstrong. Kelly Marie Brown. Savannah Cage. Christina Nicole Caulfield. Ooh. Carla Mishi Chikamoto. Abby Rebecca Coleman. Catherine Rebecca Coombs. Marielle Elise Coughlin. Casey Morris Crawford. Claire Wallace DeRose. Jillian Lee Epperson. Alana J. Field. Melissa Jean Flanagan. Laura Lee Fowler. Krista Rebecca Fullwood. Nikki Galanakis. Sarah Lee Galleon. Haley Grace Gansey. Allison Williams Garnett. Laura Elizabeth Hamrick. Haley Alexandra Harris Bloom. Sherry Maggie Ho. Olivia Jean Hodgson. Jonathan Kelly Hoffman.
Oh my goodness.
Catherine M. Horvath. Demonica Gentry Hunt. Lauren Crawford Johns. Emma Ann Katz. Sarah Marie Keener. Michaela Grace Kelly. Caroline Gaki Kalemi. Christina Michelle Kennard. Jacqueline Christiana Lawrence. Jennifer Aaron Leaf. Robert G. Leach. Michael John Leona. Melissa Aaron Lichtman. Jordan Allen Maynard. Corey Tyler Medrano. Shannon Laura Murphy. Anna Rosie Nash. Elissa Dawn Norton. Aaron Morgan O'Connor. Aaron Marie Pollock. Caitlin Rachel Porter. Summer M. Casey. Malane Rushini Rajunagaim. Amrita Keaton Ramji. Sarah Ann Ray. Emma Preston Reynolds. Neuma Carola Rodriguez. Ian Power Ryan. Lisa Marie Scully. Lauren Elizabeth Sietzma. Ann Thomas Steele. Alexis Elaine Stokes. Jessica Tang. Catherine Elizabeth Jean Teeter. Emily Margaret Thomason. Carmen Elizabeth Turner. Meredith McFerrin White. Scarlett Lindsay Whitfield. Claudia McCullough Willett. Congratulations, graduates.
Thank you for joining the faculty and congratulating our stellar graduates. I'd now like to call upon Dr. Aliki Martin, who serves as the president of the Nursing Alumni Association, to provide some closing remarks.
Good afternoon, graduates, families, and friends. On behalf of the Duke University School of Nursing Alumni Association, we are proud to be with you today to not only recognize and congratulate you on your extraordinary academic achievement, but also to welcome you into a new chapter of your life as Duke alumnus. It is our hope that your connection to Duke is a lifelong relationship, and the memories you have, and the memories you have as students will only be enhanced by the memories you create as alumni. As you move forward in your professional lives, we hope that you do so as a proud alumni of this distinguished university. Congratulations. I now invite Dean Broom back to the podium.
I'd just like to make one announcement that I overlooked earlier when I was announcing the student awards. I'd like Latifa Darden to stand up and recognize the Distinguished Dissertation Award. So, congratulations to each and every one of you. On behalf of all of us in the Duke University School of Nursing, I extend my sincere best wishes for a future of success. We also want to thank, special thanks to organist Christopher Jacobson for outstanding music throughout this hooding and recognition ceremony. And again, to members of our Office of Admissions and Student Services for planning and coordinating today's ceremony. It is quite a project. Please join me in expressing our appreciation to those individuals. And now I'd like to take just a few minutes to share a few thoughts with the graduates. As I look back over my own nursing career, which is now 43 years, I am struck, what was that groan? It's actually been a terrific time. I am struck by how nursing has evolved over time as a profession. I have seen how nursing has held on to the traditional and so important caregiving values, but has played them out in new and exciting ways. Faced with the dramatic challenges of an ever-changing healthcare delivery system, nurses are called on to lead in areas beyond hospital walls in ways never dreamed of by earlier generations. I urge each of you to assume those responsibilities and meet those challenges. We have prepared you to do that. Please play out your passions so that you can achieve your professional aspirations. For some of you, that will mean eventually returning for a master's or a DNP or a PhD. For others, however, you will immerse yourself at intervals in professional development opportunities to grow your talents and maximize your leadership strengths. As professionals, we expect all of you and know you will all be committed to lifelong learning. You are our future. Maintain the idealism and caring that made you choose to become a nurse in the first place. This is what will continue to feed your mind and your soul. Be true to the special relationships nurses have with their patients and families. As you bear witness to birth, struggles with illness and death, may the heroism and grace of your patients and their families fill you with wonder and enhance your own growth and development as both a nurse and as a person. See life's challenges as an opportunity to utilize and refine what we have taught you. These will all sound familiar. Problem solving, critical analysis, critical reasoning, methodology, and above all, communication and caring for not just your patients, but for each other and for yourself. Dynamic change is a norm in today's world. You came to us as leaders, and we have had the honor of helping to shape your leadership further. I have every confidence those abilities will serve our society well in the future. Enjoy the support of good colleagues in nursing and other health professions. Be committed to nurturing and mentoring the next generation of nurses as you have during your programs been mentored by so many, not just the faculty at Doosan, but by nurses in practice. Every one of us on the stage remembers fondly those who mentored us, each in their own way and each of us with our own personality. The common thread is that our mentors believed in us and our potential, not just to be a good nurse, but to be a great one when we did not quite see it. Remember to pay that forward. Stay connected with us. Let us know what you're doing. We take great pride in our alums and great pleasure. As you begin your practice as a professional nurse, you will join more than 6,840 graduates of the Duke University School of Nursing. Today is a milestone in your life, the closing of one chapter and the opening of another. We thank you for casting your fate with us for this short, and for some of you a longer time. And now we cast our fate with you as you begin and or continue your nursing career. I have faith that you will represent us extraordinarily well. Once again, on behalf of the Duke faculty, I would like to congratulate all of our nursing graduates from the number one school of nursing. I know some of you thought I forgot that, right? Did not. So now it's my pleasure to introduce the Doosan Nightingales, who will lead us in singing Duke's alma mater. This group includes members of our faculty, staff, and students, and they have regularly performed at school events throughout the year. At the conclusion of the alma mater, I ask that you remain seated until all faculty and graduates exit the chapel.
Thank you. send some recordings of me.